Hello guys, this is me, Dr. KQ. We were discussing the hemoglobin abnormalities, hemoglobinopathies, in which we have discussed about the beta thalassemia. We have divided the beta thalassemia into further subclassifications. Today, we are going to discuss another hemoglobinopathy, which is sickle syndrome. Sickle syndrome is a type of hemoglobinopathy which is due to the presence of sickle hemoglobin in the red blood cells. When there is a sickle hemoglobin present in the red blood cells, when these RBCs are exposed to the low oxygen tension, that is decreased oxygen tension, they will result in the sickling of the RBCs. This sickling of RBCs is seen in the sickle syndrome. We will discuss the pathogenesis later. But before that, we will describe here the three different forms of the sickle syndrome. The sickle syndrome can occur in three different forms. Number one here is as a heterozygous trait for HBS, hemoglobin S. That is, we called it sickle cell trait, which is AS. The second one here is the homozygous trait for HBS. That is the sickle cell anemia. We called it SS in a short form. The third one here is a double heterozygous trait, which can occur as a sickle beta thalassemia, sickle C disease, sickle D disease, or there can be any other abnormality structurally. So coming to the first one, that is the heterozygous trait for HBS, which is sickle cell trait. Sickle cell trait is a benign trait in which one abnormal gene is inherited, and in this condition there is no significant clinical problem seen. And when these cells are exposed to more hypoxic condition, they can also present as a sickle cell crisis. Coming to the second one, which is the most severe form, that is sickle cell anemia. We called it SS, HBSS. In sickle cell anemia, both genes are abnormal, while in this condition, only one gene is abnormal. This is the most severe form and it can decrease the life expectancy. So now we will discuss here the pathogenesis of this sickle cell anemia. In sickle cell anemia, the basic gene defect is single gene mutation, which is the substitution of the amino acid which is valine for glutamic acid at the sixth position of the codon. So this will result in the production of the abnormal hemoglobin, that is the HB alpha 2 beta 2 S, and this is the gene defect in the sickle cell anemia or HBS disease. So we were discussing the pathogenesis. In pathogenesis of sickle cell anemia, there will be the deoxygenation, and the deoxygenation of the RBC which is containing the hemoglobin S. This RBC containing the hemoglobin S will result in the sickling of RBCs or accretion shape formation of the RBCs. These are the sickle shape or the accretion shape RBCs. The mechanism which is responsible for this sickling is polymerization of the deoxygenated HBS RBC, which will then aggregate, and once it is aggregating, it is forming actually the rod-like polymers. These rod-like polymers are initially reversible. They are at reversible stage. That is, upon oxygenation, the sickle cell can be reversed. But due to the deoxygenation, or there will be the continuous deoxygenation or dehydration, which is actually due to the potassium leaving the RBCs and it is damaging the red cell membrane. So upon the continuous deoxygenation or dehydration, this will be going into the irreversible sickle cell state. So once this sickle cell irreversible state is formed, this will result in the shortened RBC life. The second one is the impaired passage through the microcirculations of the blood vessels. So microvessels are blocked and they will result in the tissue infarction. So this is how the sickling process occurs in the sickle cell anemia. The rate of the sickling depends upon, or the factors which are determining the rate of sicklings are, number one, that is deoxygenation, extent of deoxygenation. The second one is dehydration, infection, acidosis. All these are the factors which is determining the rate of the sickling process. So this is how the sickling process occurs in the sickle cell anemia. Today we are done with the sickle cell anemia, the definition, the pathogenesis involved in the sickling. Next we will discuss the clinical features and the treatment or management involved in the sickle cell anemia. So thank you very much for watching. Hope you like my video.